Hi, I'm Soumya Lakshmi. I'm a fabric artist based out of Chennai, India. I have two Facebook pages called Panchalika and Mios Collection, and on Instagram I'm under the name of Panchalika. I'm a fabric artist and I work with scrap fabrics because I believe that there is nothing called waste and nothing should unnecessarily go into a dump yard. I make dolls and wearable art out of scrap fabrics. This tutorial is for those who have a skill of embroidery or fabric painting or crochet or some other applique, some skill, and do not know how to convert their skill into a wearable art. This is for you. I'm going to be doing a Indian style blouse, a choli, that like what I'm wearing. I've done embroidery along the sleeves and at the back using anchor threads from Coats. And today I'll tell you how or where in the fabric you have to mark and do your artwork so that it can be converted into a wearable art. Things that you will need are char paper or a thick calendar sheet. I know we have to work with what we have in the present times. And 1 meter of a fabric if you're thinking of half sleeve and if you're moderately built. If you're triple XL size or more than that, then you will need 1.5 to 2 meters of the fabric. If you're thinking of a longer sleeve fabric, then you'll need 1.5 meters for a moderately built or 2 meters for a triple XL size person. You'll need your reference blouse, a well-fitted blouse. Button it up neatly, iron it out, pin the sleeves inside, and create a template. Once you pin the sleeves inside, you'll see the back of the blouse in this shape. It is always safer to draw it on a chart or a thicker calendar sheet. Once you have a reference template, you can use it multiple times for multiple works. So you can draw out on that sheet. You can fold the back of the blouse, fold the chart, and draw it out on it. Once you cut, you will have a full template ready for the back. Now fold your fabric. If you've got fabric of 1 meter, this will be the length of the fabric from where you cut to another place where you cut will be the length of the fabric. This will be the width of the fabric. The width of the fabrics will have the edges cleanly finished. The length will not have the edges cleanly finished, okay? Now, as the edges are not clearly finished, you will have to draw a clean edge using a scale and you will have to mark your reference point, reference line above the clear edge line that you've drawn. Draw it 1.5 inches above the edge line that you've drawn. You'll be doing your reference line. Why do we do this? This is the place that is going to get folded inside for the finishing of your blouse. So even if you do your work in this place, it's not going to be seen, it's going to go inside. So mark it out so that you don't do your work there. Use your template, find the midpoint, make the midpoints coincide, keep it above the reference line and draw your seam outline. Now this is going to be the place where you can do your artwork. The neck is up to you. If you want a higher neck, you can draw a higher neck. If you want a lower neck, you can draw a lower neck and do your artwork accordingly. Now turn the fabric to the other side. Draw the clear finishing edge for it using a scale. Draw the reference line 1.5 inches above it. For the sleeve, fold the sleeve of the blouse, iron it up. You will have this shape that is visible. Again, take a template cut into a chart. Once you open the folded chart, you will have a sleeve shape ready. You will have sleeves on either side. So find the midpoint of this side, find the midpoint of this side. Make the midpoint coincide with the midpoint of your template. Keep it above the reference line and trace out the outline. The same on the other side. So these are the two sleeve areas where you can do your work. This is going to go in the same. This is the area where you can do your work, and this will be going in. and the front of the blouse will be cut from these places. It is always better to buy a little extra fabric, better to use a little extra fabric, because since you will not, if you do not know sewing or you are still a learner, it is better to have the extra fabric to do the patchwork if you go wrong somewhere. You can't run around in the last minute searching for extra fabric, or you can't put in something else of a different color. It will not look good. So it is always better to buy a little extra and work on it. Hope you like this tutorial. Hope this is useful to you. Please hit a like button if you like, if you enjoyed it and if it is useful to you. I'll be doing a series of YouTube videos for blouse stitching using a reference blouse. If you want to learn further, please look into them. Thank you. Bye.